When we press the Import button in the main window and expand the Sequence Type data field, the third option allows us to import sequences from text files in EMBL or GenBank format. We click on Import and browse for the file. The next window lists the sequences found in the file. Double-clicking on a sequence opens the data in the Sequence Viewer window. In the next dialog, we will create a new import template for this kind of file format. The header fields found in the text file are listed under the column Source. We would like to use the accession number as a key field in BioNumerics. I therefore click on Accession and next on Edit Destination. Here I select the key field and click OK. Further, I would like to write the content of the source field to a new BioNumerics database information field. I can edit the name for a new entry info field or leave it as proposed. A warning pops up saying that I'm about to perform a fundamental action on the database setup. This action will be the creation of a new database information field. Please note that you need administrator privileges to do so. I confirm. By clicking the Preview button, I can check whether the fields have been assigned correctly. If so, I can close this window and click Next. As an entry link field, I use the key, as this is a unique identifier for my entries. I click Finish, and I'm prompted to give a name to the new import template. I can choose a sequence experiment that is already present in my database. Or, in case it is the first time that I import sequences from this specific gene in this database, I can create a new sequence experiment type. I will create a new sequence experiment and I'm prompted to give it a name. Again, the warning pops up saying that I'm about to perform a fundamental action on the database setup. This action will be the creation of a new sequence experiment type. Please note that you need administrator privileges to do so. I confirm. The overview dialog tells me that 14 new entries will be created in my database. As I click the Finish button, the import will start. The sequences are now added to the database and the corresponding entries are selected. By clicking on a colored dot, you can view the content of the sequence viewer. For alternative methods on sequence import and analysis, I invite you to view our other videos.